We bless the name of the Lord for such a day like this. This hour is your hour of divine visitation. Do you know that in every sickness and disease, there is a spirit behind? It is the spirit you are to address and not the symptoms. But today, let's believe the Lord together that the anointing will destroy every sickness and disease in your life. If you agree with me, say amen. Amen. Let's join them in the service.
Word of God is key to maintaining your total freedom. Let's join Pastor Amanda Ogunro of the Rivers of Living Waters Ministries for today's message. God bless you as you listen.
Today, I want to talk to you about the mysterious healing of the oil. The mysterious healing of the oil. And I'm going to take the text from James chapter 5, 14 to 15, and other scriptures as we continue the message. It is good to know, why are we calling oil mysterious? The oil is mysterious because of its unusual power in action. And this power includes authority to drive out evil spirits and the anointing to heal all manner of sickness and disease. No ordinary oil can offer this service. Not engine oil, palm oil, kerosene and oil, and etc. No, none. What's so special about this oil, when we call it the mysterious oil? It's mysterious because it has a lot of power. And it has a lot of authority. It also has unusual things inside. We will see this as we continue the message. Now, I want you to turn your Bible to James chapter 5, 14 to 15. Let's read it together. James 5, 14 to 15. Is any sick among you? Let him call for the elders of the church and let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. And the power of faith shall save the sick, and the Lord shall raise him up. And if he had committed sin, they shall be forgiven him. Yeah. Don't you see, it's a wonderful oil. If you counted the 14, 15 verses, him, individual, there are five. Everyone was going to see Jesus. There is a particular person the Lord started talking to. That person may be any of you to hear today. Yeah. Is any sick among you? That question simply means that there is power to destroy every manner of sicknesses and disease. There's power for it. It's capable to handle any sick among you. Is there anyone sick among you? Remember last time we taught on the greatest prescription, and that was the Word of God. Jeremiah 46:11. He said, go up into Gilead and take balm. The balm is the word of God. In other words, the greatest physician has started with the prescription of the word of God, number one. Psalm 107, verse 20 said, he sent his word to heal and to deliver them from their destruction. He sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destruction. Has the power to heal, has the power to deliver. In other words, to heal the sick is a game of power. And that power is here today.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now the second one, the second prescription is the anointing oil. Is Jesus who is prescribing them, prescribing this oil. He said, is any sick among you? Let him call for the elders of the church and let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer of faith shall save the sick, and the Lord shall raise him up.
Yes.
Is any sick among you? That's consultation. Let him call for the elders of the church and let them pray over him, prescription. Anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord, and the prayer of faith shall save the sick, and the Lord shall raise him up.
Amen.
That's treatment. Are we ready?
Yes.
When we look at James 5, 14 to 15, the Lord is telling you that there is no manner of sickness and disease that he cannot take care of. Is there any?
No.
Is there any?
No.
If you know, you have something that the Lord cannot do, so let us know. But he's telling us that the power of the Lord is equal to the task. He can do and not do. He has the power to create. He has the power to cut off. He has the power to heal. And that's why Psalm 107, 20 said, he said his word and healed them and delivered them from their destruction. You'll be healed this morning in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Viewers by television. Amen.
Amen.
I want us to quickly look at Matthew chapter 10, verse 1. Matthew 10, 1. And when he had called unto him his 12 disciples, he gave them power against unclean spirits to cast them out and to heal all manner of sickness and all manner of disease. In other words, all manner of sickness, all manner of disease, whether physical or spiritual. No matter. All manner of sickness, all manner of disease. The power of God is equal to the task. And all you need is to walk into your liberty.
Amen.
And you are walking into that liberty today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Total Freedom. We'll be right back.
From the list of Pastor Amanda Oguro's publication, we introduced three great books, True Deliverance, to show you the way out of bondage, to be delivered and live a victorious life, The Reality of Dreams. It is an expository book on what dreams are, their sources, their purposes, as well as understanding the secrets of satanic oppression. It gives you knowledge, confidence, and strategy to dislocate the devil. Grab your copy at the nearest bookshop or come to Rivers of Living Water Ministries, 540 Ikuruturu Road, Maryland, Dostop, Lagos.
It's over now. is over now.
Welcome back to Total Freedom.
See, what is happening here is so unique. When the enemy comes in, first of all, let us look at it. That every sickness and disease, there's always a spirit behind. It is the spirit that Jesus is dealing with. I've experienced it personally myself. You see somebody who is very, very sick unto death. Once that spirit of infirmity is cast out, instantly, the person recovered. Like a lady who came, when he came, this is the way he was walking, was holding his side, he was walking, like, could not stand straight, was walking like this. What's the problem? He said, I can't stand straight. I said, remove your hand. Jesus is going to take it away from you now. And after the prayer, this young lady started doing aerobics, started jumping up, started crying and said, I've never seen anything like that. Your Jesus is wonderful. Amen. Tell somebody beside you, Jesus is wonderful. When he comes upon the strong man, the first thing he does is he disarmed him. He disarmed him. And after disarming him, he forced him to release the captives. And he has no other choice. And that's why Luke 11:22 made it clear. He said, but when a stronger than he shall come upon him and overcome him, he taketh from him all his armor where he trusted and divide his spoils. All. Everybody say all. In other words, Isaiah 49:24-25 is agreeing with Luke 11:22. Shall the prey be taken from the mighty, or the lawful captive delivered? But thus says the Lord, even the captives of the mighty shall be taken away, and the prey of the terrible shall be delivered. Amen. Shall death deliverance is mine today in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. By the time we finish this anointing, you will walk into your liberty. Amen. Since we said we are talking about the mysterious healing of the oil, it is good to know what is in the oil. The things that are in the oil that makes the oil to be mysterious. What is in the oil? Let's go to 1 Samuel chapter 16, look at 13. Then Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the midst of his brethren. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon David from that forward. Just underline, from that forward. Then Samuel took the horn of the oil and anointed him in the midst of his brethren. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon David from that day forward. So Samuel rose up and went to Ramah. What is this saying? In other words, what is in the oil? The Spirit of the Lord is in the oil. The Spirit of the Lord is in the oil. You can see from this verse, he said, from that day forward, after David has been anointed, he became another man. That no evil spirit can stand before him. Even when Saul was undergoing some terrible satanic oppression, nobody could do anything to him. Is David. Go to 23 of the same verse for confirmation. And it came to pass, when the evil spirit from God was upon Saul, that David took an harp and played with his hand. So Saul was what? Refreshed and was what? Well. And the evil spirit, what happened? Departed from him. All because of what? The anointing. The anointing. What is in the oil? Go to Samuel, 1 Samuel chapter 10. We look at verse 6. We're analyzing now the mysterious oil. What is in the oil? Verse 6. And the Spirit of the Lord will come upon thee, and thou shalt prophesy with them, and thou shalt be turned into what? Another man. It is the anointing that can turn somebody to another thing, another man. What human being cannot do, there will be a great transformation. Once the anointing comes into action of that person's life. Go to verse 9. And it was so, that when he had turned his back to go from somewhere, God gave him another heart. And all those signs came to pass that day. Spiritually, another heart simply means the spirit. So long as the spirit that used to be operating him. And they go to verse 10. And when they came to that to the hill, behold, a company of prophets met him, and the Spirit of God came upon him. What happened? And he prophesied among them. Was he a prophet? No. But I tell you that there's something mysterious about this powerful Holy Spirit. If you come in contact with your enemy, we destroy them. If you come in contact with somebody who loves you, he will fall in love with that person. Your enemy is his enemy. Your friend is his friend. Amen? So I feel sorry for those who will make the anointed their enemy. They are finished. What did I say? They are finished. The spirit in the oil, once it touches or have an encounter with an enemy that is inside or that is outside and is coming through dream for oppression, what does he do? He stops him from afflicting you. He stopped him from having his way against you. And after stopping him, he delivers you from his hand. And that's what Isaiah 59:19 talks about. So shall they fear the name of the Lord from the west, and his glory from the rising of the sun. When the enemy shall come in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord shall lift up a standard against him. So one of the functions of the flood is that he will lift a standard against your enemy. He will make him to start doing wickedness to himself rather than doing wickedness to you. Because the Holy Ghost has a standard. Amen? Praise the Lord. What is in the oil? It works deliverance for individual. It's working deliverance for everyone that has that anointing. Amen? What is in the oil? Let's go to Matthew chapter 3, 11 to 12. Matthew 3. I indeed baptize you with water unto repentance. But he that cometh after me is mightier than I, whose shoes I am not worthy to bear. He shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire, whose fan is in his hand. And he will totally purge his floor and gather his wheat into the garner. But he will burn up the chaff with unquenchable fire. Everybody say amen.
Amen.
That's powerful revelation there. What is in the oil? He is telling you that the Holy Ghost is in the oil. And you are the temple of the Holy Ghost. 1 Corinthians 6:19. What? Know ye not that you are the temple of God, which is in you, which you have of God, and you are not your own. You are the temple of the Holy Ghost, and it's inside you. And he cannot live in a dirty vessel. He cannot live in anything that wants to pollute where he lives.
Total Freedom. We'll be right back.
It's over now.
Welcome back to Total Freedom.
So when he gets there, there's something start happening. And he's telling you that in his hands, the Holy Ghost hands, he has a fan. And that fan, he uses to sweep the floor. You are the floor he's sweeping. He's using that fan to sweep the floor. He garnish the floor. And after sweeping the floor, what happened? The chaff, the dirt, the things that are not supposed to be in your life, that is hindering you from serving God. The things that are not supposed to be in your life, that is making you to say, where is my God? The things that are not supposed to be in your life, that is making you to start asking questions, negative questions, and will negate your faith. And what happened? That chaff. It could be HIV. It could be cancer. It could be AIDS. It could be malaria. It could be typhoid. It could be heart disease. It could be liver disease. It could be impotency. It could be infertility. And whatsoever my heavenly Father has not planted must be rooted up. How does he root it up? By sweeping the floor. Your floor will be swept today in Jesus' name. Your floor will be swept clean today in Jesus' name. I say your floor will be swept clean today in Jesus' name. You're not going to go back the same way you came. Ha ha. It garnish. Garnish. Then what happened? As he's sweeping the dirt and etc., he gathered the chaff and he consumed the chaff with his unquenchable fire. Amen. Hebrews 12:29 says, for what? Our God is a consuming fire. After sweeping the floor, which you are, the thing he has swept out, he doesn't throw them away to the dustbin. By venture, something will happen and they come back. He burned them. And as he's burning them, he's preserving you. Amen. To make sure that your life will not be afflicted again. Amen. He's purging, he's sweeping, he's cleansing, he's sanctifying you. Amen. Amen. What is in the oil? The Holy Ghost. The duty of the fan in his hand is to sweep the floor. He has a duty. It's designed. That fan is designed by the Lord. And in his hand, he's holding it. And start checking inside you. One thing I want you to know, if somebody wants to sweep inside this church, and the doors are locked, can you come in? Then there's no way the floor can be swept clean. So before he can come in to sweep the floor, what happened? The doors will be open. So he can come inside. And once he gets inside, what happened? He starts sweeping and cleansing and removing. Stand up and start thanking the Holy Spirit. Start thanking the Holy Spirit. All manner of sickness, the Lord is removing them. All manner of sickness. Amen. All manner of sickness and disease. Be seated, please. All manner. When he come in contact with the enemy, he said, leave him and let him go. He said, because I am stronger than you. There's power in the anointing oil. Some years ago, a lady came for counseling and deliverance. He was told to come. He's been having disappointments in the area of marriage. Anytime a man proposed to marry her, a day before the wedding, this woman would develop terrible stomach pain. When the man is around, only when the man is around, she will develop terrible stomach pain. She will fall down, be fainting, and be holding her stomach, and be crying, oh, my stomach. After the whole show is over, the man will say, I don't want to marry again. She had that nasty experience for six suitors, six. It was then somebody now said, go to this church, the Lord will deliver you there. So she came, narrated all her story. So I prayed with her. And I took a shot of the oil. First of all, I asked her, go and buy anointing oil and bring it. She brought it. I don't want any story. I said, she has one oil. When she gives you, something will happen. There is something in that oil. I don't do that. Bring it. I will bless it in your presence. So she went. She brought it. Opened it. We prayed on it. What was the prayer? That's the prayer I'm praying for you today. Lord, you have a fan in your hand. Sweep inside her out and burn the shaft. She went home. According to her testimony, she said around 11 o'clock in the night, she just felt she's going to ease herself. And she started stooling. And the stooling was taking a different tone. And after a very long time, she said she has never had such an experience before. Then she finally now got up. When he looked into the toilet, a snake. Talim is her name. She stool a snake, a serpent. Black, long, coily, started screaming. They now came, remove the snake and kill it and burn it. 3 months later, she got married. So the purpose of that snake was to make sure she will never be married. Anything the enemy puts into your body, he has a plan for it. And when that time comes to manifest, it's not manifesting according to the program of the enemy. But in your own case today, he will die in Jesus' name. He will come out, whether you like it or not, by force or by fire, because there is fire in the oil.
Your salvation is our greatest concern. If you have not received Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, please say this prayer with me. Lord Jesus, I come to you today. I am a sinner. I cannot help myself. Forgive me my sins. Cleanse me with your blood. Deliver me from sin and Satan to serve you, the living God. Today, Jesus, I accept you as my Lord and personal Savior. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me. I declare that I am born again. Amen. Congratulations on your new journey to gaining total freedom. Kindly contact us for a free copy of Pastor Amanda Ogunro's book, The Greatest Miracle.
I believe you've been blessed by this message. And if you need more of our messages, please kindly contact us at number 540 Ikorodu Road, Maryland, Lagos.
Or call us on these numbers 0909-462-8309 or 0903-496-493 and 0705-02-19571
or email us at info@rlwm.org. God bless you.